Hey everyone, this is a review of Milwaukee's new M12 Fuel 4-in-1 installation driver, model number 2505-20 for bare tool, -22 for a kit. So let's go ahead and take a closer look at this thing, and I'll tell you what I like about it and what I don't like about it.
Alright, so here's the tool up close. You can tell it's really lightweight and compact. It's 2 pounds with a battery, 1 pound, 9.5 ounces bare tool, super lightweight. When you add the different attachments, it gets a little bit heavier. So if you just want 2 pounds, you've got the magnetic quarter inch bit holder here. If you want the locking bit adapter, this one adds about 5 ounces. And then the 3/8 inch chuck, the offset adapter, and the right angle adapter all add about 8 to 9 ounces each. So in comparison, the Gen 2 Fuel hammer drill here, this one in the M12 system is 2 pounds 12 ounces, so it's a full 12 ounces heavier than the installation driver. That one has 350 inch-pounds of torque, the installation driver has 300 inch-pounds of torque. So with that huge reduction in weight, they didn't actually sacrifice that much in performance. Now also you'll notice the head on this one is a lot slimmer, which lets you get into tighter areas, and the overall length is right at 5.5 inches without any attachments on it. So you can get this in pretty tight places as it is. It's designed with the grip for your hand to go right on back and hold it with your thumb and index finger up top and your middle finger on the trigger. I like holding drills like this and I find it really comfortable. And the only time I hold this one like, you know, down on the handle like a regular drill is when I've got something really high torque that I need the extra leverage for, like lag bolts that I've driven with this and it didn't have any problems. So overall though, I like holding it like this, and the contours are a little bit off if you hold it down below like a regular drill. Just a heads up on that, it's meant to be held like this. As far as controls go, on top, you've got your forward reverse switch, so it's not quite standard, and you know, normally a drill has a little thing right here, and you can feel if you're in forward or reverse. This one, you actually have to look at it. So that's a detraction. I don't like the fact that if you've, you know, you got the drill in somewhere, and you're like, oh man, did I leave that in forward or reverse? You gotta pull it out to look at it. And then you gotta just hit forward or reverse for back, to toggle back and forth between the two. If you hold this down, it will lock it. I thought this was gonna be a huge pain, but it's actually, you can do it one-handed. You can just slide your thumb right up here and hit that button. And you can do it with your index finger too if you want to. So you don't need two hands to switch this back and forth, but you just don't have the tactile feedback of if you're in forward or reverse without having to take your hands off the trigger and everything. Speed selection is up top here. You've got a high speed low torque mode and a low speed high torque mode. That's going to be 400 RPM topping out in speed 1, and in speed 2 you get 1600 RPM. On the front is your selection collar. You've got drill and then 16 different clutch position settings. This is a mechanical clutch. I think a lot of people will be happy to hear that. And it's pretty repeatable as far as my testing's gone, and it's got pretty good resolution across the range of torque modes that you'll want to use it with. On the side here is your battery gauge, and then on the front, you've got a magnetic bit holder. You can put bits in if you're not using them or if you're swapping out drill bits and driver bits, and it's actually pretty secure for holding those in place. On the right here, you've got an LED. It's not super bright and it's not super accurate. If you've just got like the drill or whatever chuck attachment here, it hits below where you're actually aiming at, and you still got shadows from your bit and your chuck and whatever. So I prefer one down here at the bottom. Not a big deal though. It still lights up enough when you're in a cabinet or something like that to be able to see what you're doing. Another thing they did to slim down the head of the drill is they took the electronics that normally sit right here and they moved them to this handguard. So that's part of the reason you have this handguard out here, and it allows them to, you know, what you really usually have trouble with getting into places is the head of the drill, and this handguard doesn't extend past the front. Now let's get into the attachments. You've got the quarter inch locking bit holder. To put these on, you just pull back on the collar like that and slide them in and they lock into place. For the bits, you can just slide your quarter inch bit in and it's locked into place, and then to remove it, you pull on the bit holder and release. So I like the way this one's designed. It's very natural, very intuitive, and it, you know, doesn't have you fumbling for a bit when you're trying to insert one. Next is the 3/8 inch chuck. I've used this with some pretty beefy bits. I used this with a 1 3/8 inch Forstner. I was really surprised that the drill could handle it. But it managed to do so. The only problem was with this drill chuck on extremely large bits like that one, I actually had problems with it slipping a little bit. I had it really cranked down, but it was still slipping occasionally. Now that 1 3/8 inch bit is really bigger than this is meant to be used for, but if you do have really high torque situations, this thing might not be able to hold on to the bit you've got in it. Next up, the offset adapter, probably my favorite adapter in this whole thing. Pops in and it lets you get really close to a surface when you're drilling or driving against it. So from the center line of your drill bit to the edge of a surface, if you've got something and you're trying to butt it up against like this and drive right into that corner, you've got just 3/8 of an inch from that surface to the center line of what you're trying to drill into. Now, one downside to this thing is this is just a magnetic bit holder. It is not a locking bit holder. So if you are trying to drill with it, you are going to leave your drill bit in the material a lot, and you'll have to just pull that drill bit back out and pop it back into the driver. So something to keep in mind, if you do a lot of pilot hole drilling in offset corners, this one's gonna be annoying. It's great for driving screws though, but just keep in mind if you're drilling, you're gonna be fishing your drill bit out of the workpiece a lot. Next up, the right angle adapter. This one's also super useful for cabinets or any tight access places that you're trying to drill and drive in. Once again, you can lock it into any different 16 different indexing positions. Unfortunately, if you get it in the wrong one, which I do quite often, you have to pull the whole thing out and kind of try to re-index it. And sometimes it just does not want to engage. So I spend a little bit extra time with this thing fumbling around with it. It's not quite as smooth as some of the other systems with adjustable adapters like this one is. It's just a little bit harder to get it engaged. You spend a few extra seconds each time. If you've got a 1-inch insert bit in the magnetic bit holder here, it's just 2 3/4 inches clearance that you need to fit this anywhere. Now, this right angle adapter, you can also fit any of these other attachments on it. So if you need to use a drill chuck with it, you can. If you need to use the offset adapter, you can. So something like this, super handy when you've just got crazy access to places and you just can't get anything else in there. This thing can save the day. So overall, I think this tool is super useful. I just moved houses and I've been doing a bunch of random projects. Lots of stuff with cabinets, installing new shelf pin jigs, installing pull-out inserts in cabinets, hanging a new TV with lag bolts, installing curtain rods, just lots of random various tasks. And this and all of its attachments have come really in handy for doing all of that. So it's a very versatile tool. I mean, you can get away with not buying a right-angle drill, you know, a specialty tool, just by having this one, which can do a variety of different tasks. So it's a great jack-of-all-trades tool. If you've got a carrying case where you keep all of these on hand and you don't have to go find them, it can save you a lot of time from not having to go dig up a specialty tool when you figure out you need it.
Price point on this thing is $230 for a 2-battery kit. That's 2 2-amp-hour batteries that come with it, as well as the case and all 4 attachments. If you already have enough M12 batteries, you can get this with the 4 attachments, bare tool for $180. I think that's a really reasonable price. The only similar tool that I know of that beats that is the Bosch flexi-click, which is a little bit cheaper. All the other ones, the Festool, Metabo, 12-volt drivers like this one, similar to it with all the different head attachments, are quite a bit more expensive. So thanks to Milwaukee for providing this for me to review. Hopefully you found it helpful, and let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. And once again, don't forget to subscribe.